St. Paul United Methodist Church. It is an honor to worship with you. God bless all of you.
Welcome to Video Worship with St. Paul's United Methodist Church. I'm Amy Jo Burr, the pastor of St. Paul's, and I welcome you to join our congregation in prayer and praise today. We want to say thank you to Ezra Tuwalo, who provided our prelude for us this morning, Amazing Grace, while you saw greeting photos of our congregation. And we look forward to hearing from Ezra later in the service when he'll sing an additional piece of special music for us, the song Rise Up. We have just a few announcements before we begin. As we move into the fall season, there are two new groups forming for Christian education and spiritual growth. There is a friendship meditation group. If you have an interest in silent meditation with this group, they're meeting on Friday evenings, and you can contact Jane Spaulding for more information. There's also a Christian education group forming. They will meet by Zoom video conference. And for more information on that group, you can contact Charles Duddingston. Finally, we want to say thank you to all who have shown their great generosity toward the kingdom of God and have made special gifts to St. Paul's United Methodist Church or to our partners in mission. Today especially, we want to highlight that we're beginning a funding drive for school supplies for Garlow School. In past years, we have brought school supplies to the church narthex, but because we are not meeting in person, we're suggesting that we raise funds and send in money for the school social worker to be able to purchase supplies for those students who need help being able to purchase those. So if you're sending in a special gift for Garlo, we thank you. Your gift makes a difference in the lives of others. Other needs related to Garlo as they begin this school year are pen pals. If you would like to write back and forth and help develop writing skills in one of the Garlo students, we would love to have as many pen pals as possible from St. Paul's United Methodist Church. There's also a possibility, which we're working out, for reading buddies to be able to continue via video conference, and more information for that will be forthcoming. And finally, if you are a mask sewer, some additional children's size masks would be in order for Garlo School. I know as a mom, I think about masks and the small piece of fabric, and I have to think that they might get lost almost as often as mittens get lost during the winter, just because of their small size. So if you are sewing masks and want to make a few children's size for Garlo's, extras will always be helpful. So all of these things are things that you can do if you want to help to reach out to our partner school, Garlo Environmental Magnet School. We thank all who have given special gifts to Garlo School, to the school drive, and to St. Paul's for the work of the Kingdom of God through the mission of St. Paul's United Methodist Church. Your gifts make a difference. Let's begin our worship service now as we look to God in prayer. Loving God, we thank you that you watch over us at all times in our lives. And as we begin a new school year, we pray that you will especially watch over all of our friends at Garlo School, the students, the teachers, the staff, all who enter that building. We pray, O God, that they would be blessed by you. We pray that you would fill their minds with beautiful new learnings, and that you would help keep them safe and joy-filled. We pray, O God, now for each one who is watching video worship, that as they turn their hearts towards you, you would reach out to them and provide a special inspiration or a word of hope for their lives. All of this we pray in the name of your blessed Son, Jesus. Amen. And now we begin our singing for the day with Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. Lane will lead us. Won't you join me in singing?
Love Divine, All Loves Excelling, joy of heaven to earth come down. Fix in us thine humble dwelling, all thy faithful mercies round. Jesus, thou art our compassion, pure and bound in love thou art. Visit us with thy salvation, enter every trembling heart. Come, Almighty, to deliver, let us all thy life receive. Suddenly return and never more thy temples leave. Thee we would be always blessing, serve thee as thy hosts above. Pray and praise thee without ceasing, glory in thy perfect love. Finish then thy new creation, pure and spotless let us be. Let us see thy great salvation, perfectly restored in thee. Change from glory into glory, till in heaven we take our place. Till we cast our crowns before thee, lost in wonder, love, and praise. Till we cast our crowns before thee, lost in wonder, love, and praise.
Today's gospel reading is from Matthew 22, verses 35 through 40. One of them, a lawyer, asked Jesus a question to test him. Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest? He said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Good morning. Today we'll be reading The Greatest Commandment from our Spark Storybook Bible.
The Greatest Commandment. The Pharisees were a group of people who had lots and lots of laws. Altogether, they had more than 600. Woo! That's a lot of rules to follow. One day, one of the Pharisees said to Jesus, Teacher, what's the greatest law? He didn't think Jesus could possibly pick just one law out of so many. He was trying to trick Jesus. But Jesus knew the man was trying to trick him. He looked at the man and smiled. Love God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, Jesus said. This is the greatest of all commandments. But there's another really important one, too. Love your neighbor as yourself. If you obey these two laws, then you obey all of the laws. The Pharisees' jaws dropped to the floor. They were shocked to know just how smart Jesus was. They were surprised Jesus had answered their question and turned their trick around on them. They didn't know what to say.
In today's story, the Pharisees were trying to trick Jesus into choosing which the laws were the most important to follow. But Jesus knew if we loved everyone and respected everyone, all of the rules and laws would be covered. I imagine that most of you have seen a list of rules in your classroom at school and at home. Things like no hitting or yelling or taking something that doesn't belong to you. Having a rule of always showing love and respect to each other covers all of that too. If we would all show love and respect to everyone, we wouldn't even need those rules. Now, when Jesus said, love your neighbor as yourself, do you think he meant only your immediate neighbors who live next to you? Or only neighbors that look like you, or only the neighbors that enjoy the same activities of you? No, of course not. He meant your neighbors in a neighboring town, and even your neighbors in another state. He met your neighbors that have different skin colors or speak different languages. He met your neighbors that are Vikings fans as well as your neighbors that are Packers fans. No matter what makes us different, he wants us to love everyone. And that is our greatest commandment.
Today's gospel reading contains the golden rule. During this back-to-school time of the year, I'm thinking a lot about how I'm growing and learning. And the golden rule is one way that Christians can always be growing and learning. The golden rule is so simple. Love your neighbor as yourself. As we model our lives after the life of Christ, this should be a very simple thing to do. And yet, it takes a whole lifetime to be able to live into loving our neighbor as ourselves. There can even be times when it may just seem overwhelming. In the midst of problems around us, problems in our society, problems in the greater world, how are we to love our neighbor? Sometimes it takes creativity, and sometimes it just plain takes perseverance. In the midst of it all, I want to remind you that the power of God has the strength to help us continue to rise up and to love our neighbor as ourself. And so we welcome Ezra to inspire us in song, reminding us how the power of God's love and hope can help us to rise up. Ezra, will you please lead us in song?
You're broken down and tired, living life on the merry-go-round. And I can't see that fighter, but I see it in you. Work it out. Move, mountain. Mountains, and I'll rise up, rise like the day, and I'll rise up, rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it 1,000 times again. And I'll rise up, high like the waves, and I'll rise up, despite all the pain. I'll rise up, and I'll do it 1,000 times again. And for you, yeah, for you. When the silence isn't quiet, and it feels like it's hard to breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise you, we'll bring the world to its feet. Move, mountain, and move, mountain, and I'll rise up, rise like and I'll rise up, rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it 1,000 times again. For you, yeah, for all of you.
Listen up, United Methodist Church.
All we need is hope, for that we have each other. We have each other. And we will rise, we'll rise, because we have each other. We have each other, and I'll rise up like light today, and I rise up unafraid, and I rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I rise up high like the winds, and I rise up despite all the pain. I rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. For all of you, all we need is love, for that we have each other, we have each other.
Aloha, God bless all of you.
The power of God does strengthen us so that we can rise up and fully love God and love our neighbor as ourselves. As I said before, the commandment to love our neighbor as ourselves is simple to understand, but takes a lifetime to be able to fulfill. I think of the many, many ways that our congregation in St. Paul's has been involved in loving our neighbor as ourselves through different mission and outreach opportunities. Just to name a few, we've been involved with eradicating malaria, providing clean water globally, stopping gang activity, supporting victims of domestic violence, ending homelessness, supporting those in recovery from addiction, supporting those struggling with poverty in our community, ending the racial achievement gap in Minnesota schools, and so many others. Those are just a few that came to my mind. I remind you that we began today's worship service with an announcement about how you can be involved in helping our partner school, Garlow School, and shining Christ's light brightly there. I hope all of the people of St. Paul's will take a moment and consider if there is a way that you can be involved in either helping to support school supplies for children who need them, being a pen pal, a reading buddy by video, or perhaps by sewing a child-sized mask to be able to donate for extras. All these are ways of loving our neighbor through Garlow School. There are many ways that we can show love of God and neighbor, but I want to comment on a few that have been before us because of our current historical context. The first has to do with racial reconciliation. Our book club right now is reading a book by Kendi called How to Be an Anti-Racist. And this book puts forth the idea that we shouldn't simply be neutral towards racism and then congratulate ourselves that we haven't been furthering it. Instead, we should be actively working to be anti-racist, or actively working to show God's love by developing relationships and building bridges between people of different races. This is part of our work as peacemakers in the world, and this is part of our work at helping the whole world realize that in Christ we are all brothers and sisters. Working towards the goal of anti-racism may begin with something as small as making a new friend who is a different race from you. But when we begin to take these simple steps, sometimes we find ourselves blocked by the current systems that are in place. Sometimes unspoken systems that separate out our races. And so we pause to consider the idea that when we live in a society where racism is present, there are sometimes unseen systems within that society which help to continue the status quo. This is why Kendi's book is pushing us towards the idea that we need to actively work to dismantle any systems that keep us apart from one another. So instead of being apart from one another, we instead can move closer together, learn to know one another, and better be able to love all of our neighbors as ourselves. Second, I wanted to talk about the inclusion of gays, lesbians, bisexuals, and transgendered persons in our denomination, the United Methodist Church. Right now, we have had a temporary pause on denominational discussions in this because our international meeting, our last general conference, had to be postponed because we were not permitted to gather in large numbers at that time due to COVID. The meeting has been rescheduled and we are working towards getting together. But until then, the Minnesota Annual Conference, our statewide organization, has put together a statement of inclusion, encouraging all our congregations to reach out with Christ's love and include gays, lesbians, bisexual, and transgendered persons in what we do in every way we can. This resolution was passed by a supermajority at last year's annual conference, and it encourages us to simply reach out in love, no matter what a person's sexual orientation might be, to focus on building loving relationships with them and reaching out with the love of Christ to all. And finally, our current historical context is putting before us all the time our response to COVID-19. We realize that because each person infected is usually infected for a few days before they realize they are sick, and during this time can spread the disease to others. We realize the importance of all the public health precautions that we can take to prevent the disease from spreading in our communities. So things like washing our hands, wearing our masks, and social distancing, while very basic things, can be very important to stopping the spread of this disease. We particularly pay attention to this because Christ asks us to love our neighbors as ourselves, and we know that God has a special heart for those who are most vulnerable. In this case, that means our elderly populations and our people who are immune compromised. We do not know when we are shopping at the same grocery store with a worker from a nursing care facility, and we do not know when we are otherwise encountering a nurse or a healthcare worker on the street. We want to make sure that we do what we can to limit the spread of disease as a way of showing love for our neighbor, just to help protect the most vulnerable in our communities. This is one thing that we can do to show our love of neighbor in a simple manner, is to pass on the gift of good health. Although these three things which I mentioned to you are ever before us because of the historical time period in which we live, I remind you too, there are so many ways to reach out with Christ's love. Look for a way in your life today when you can reach out. A hand of friendship, a hand of kindness, and a hand that shares the love of Christ with someone near to you. May God bless you as you are able to rise up, love God, and truly live out your calling to love your neighbor as yourself. Amen.
Thank you.
as God's people, we long for a day when we will be able to walk together in unity in Christ. And so let that be our prayer today as we begin, that we might be able to walk with each other in Christ's love and in unity in Christ. Let us pray. God of all peoples, in your great love, you have adopted us as your very own children. Through your salvation, we are united as brothers and sisters. Help us to celebrate with each other's joys rather than to be envious or jealous. Let us walk together with joy.
Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned, where love shines through.
We pray, O God, for an end to racism. Where there are divisions amongst us, bring healing. Give us the creativity needed to build bridges between all people, and help us to remember that we are united in Jesus Christ. Let us walk together in unity.
Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned, where love shines through.
We pray today for all who are ill, hospitalized, injured, or grieving. Especially, we pray for all who are sick with COVID-19. And especially, we pray for the nurses at Bethesda Hospital who are attending our COVID patients there. As we care for one another during our times of pain, our love for each other is multiplied and our pain is divided. Let us walk together in love.
Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned, where love shines through.
God of new life, we place in your care all who are struggling with addiction, those in active addiction, those in relapse, those in recovery. Give them special strength during this time when access to support groups is sometimes limited by social distancing. Help us all to place you at the center of our lives and guide us to provide support and accountability for one another. Let us walk together with hope.
Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned, where love shines through.
We pray today for all who live in poverty or struggle to meet their basic needs, for those who are seeking employment, and those who toil at jobs which do not pay a living wage. Teach us to share what we have with glad and generous hearts, trusting that together there will be enough for all with 12 baskets left over. Let us walk together with kindness.
Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned, where love shines through.
As the new school year begins, we pray for all of the students, teachers, and staff returning to school. Especially we pray for all of the students, teachers, staff, reading buddies, and pen pals at Garlow School, our partner school. As they begin this new year, we pray that you will keep them safe and fill them with the joy of new learnings. Teach us, O God, to better love our neighbor. Let us walk together in Christ's love. Amen.
Walk with me, with me, I will walk with you and build the land that God has planned, where love shines through.
Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
We come now to God's table of Holy Communion. Won't you join me in blessing these communion elements together? As we pray, I remind you that it doesn't matter if you're a member of this church or of any church. God's table is open to all who hear God's call to join him and be renewed by this holy meal. Let us pray together. Creator God, we give you thanks for the wheat and the grapes which come to us on this table of Holy Communion. We give you thanks for the way that your breath of life flows through all of the creation around us. Especially we thank you today, O God, for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who came to earth in human form, who died and rose again for our sake. We remember how Jesus called disciples to follow him, how he gathered them in an upper room, took bread and cup, gave thanks to you, shared them, and said, "This is my body and my blood, poured out and broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And so we come to this holy table, O God, in remembrance of that day and looking forward to the great feast to come when all will feast together in the presence of God. And now, O Lord, we ask you to pour out your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and juice, not only on the bread and juice here with me today, but on the bread and juice in the hands of all who participate. Make it be for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, that we might be fed by your hand and renewed in your spirit, sent out in ministry to all the world. This we pray in the name of your blessed Son, Jesus. Amen. The body of Christ, broken for you and for me, the blood of Christ, shed for you and for me for the forgiveness of sins. Amen. We give thanks for this gift of Holy Communion. Our final hymn today is The Gift of Love. Lane will lead us in singing. Won't you join in song?
Though I may speak and have the gift to awe inspire, but have not love, my words are vain as sounding brass and hopeless gain. Though I may grieve all I possess and strive be made known. Let inward love guide every deed. By this we worship and are
Let us go with God's blessings. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and bring you peace. Amen.